the whole garage studio, relatively uneducated young people were actually producing records, and that just didn't happen in those days. Hal was very much a school and a playground for nutty people that were learning about the music business. I didn't know what I was doing, but I knew what was supposed to come out of there, which was good sounding records.
Wipeout.
Wipeout seems to capture a primary chord in generation after generation, not only here, but around the world.
I really believe that there's a lot of Paul Buff and Frank Zappa.
We had a really natural affinity. We were both there. The odds were against us, but we didn't care.
When we first walked in there and we saw Frank Zappa, he was like a skinny guy our age with greasy hair. And we thought, are this kid going to record this? Boy, did he show us. He knew what he was doing.
We started rehearsing that music in Cucamonga. We would rehearse almost every day, all day.
Zappa's a hard guy to pigeonhole. I think he really was one of the geniuses of the last century in terms of popular music.
It's a good IQ test. If you like the music, you're smart. And if you don't like the music, you're dumb. So find out yourself whether you're smart or stupid.
Gently, come on, take my love.